So today we are going to discuss about phenols. Okay, so that is nothing but our benzene ring with OH. This is our phenol. So you'll be familiar with this once I take this thing fully. So first topic, preparation of phenol. So first one is from benzene via sulfonation. Okay, fine. So I just want to draw the benzene here, benzene structure, sulfonation. So I'll get what? Benzene sulfonic acid I'll get. Benzene sulfonic acid. This is SO3H. So in your board exam, you need not write the intermediate. Okay. And this again will give us in presence of NaOH. And hydrogenation, NaOH and H plus meaning hydrogenation. So every compound will use what NaOH thing. Okay, will give us our corresponding answer for this. So this is my OH here, and this is my phenol. So please copy down this thing once and let me know. So guys, I'm giving time for you to complete this thing. So while you're completing, I just want to tell you that if I'm able to complete this organic chemistry fast, it will be helpful for you only. Okay, because I can send you the same videos which you are in the class, and then you can try to recollect the same and thus improve your memory. Completed. Yeah. Fine. So I'm just going to the next page. Okay. So I hope someone else is done. Yeah, perfect. From disodium salt. So I have told you from the previous chapter also, disodium N2 plus X minus. You'll study more of this in amines chapter. Okay, this particular thing. Fine. N2 plus X, disodium means what? N2 plus X minus. X mean halogen. This is the disodium salt. Okay. So again, I have to draw the compound then. Guys, I'm trying my level best to make sure that it is good looking for you, all of you. Okay. So to assume that how much effort I'm putting, double effort you have to put to get the good marks. 2HCl plus NaNO2, sodium nitrate, or treating with nitrous acid, you can say. NaNO2 plus HCl, you can say nitrous acid, totally. This is with respect to heating, delta heating. Will give me a diazonium salt. Okay, so this in turn will give me a benzene diazonium chloride. So first let me draw, later on I'll explain you. N2Cl. I told you this is N2X minus, so N2Cl. That's all. Nitrogen is double bonded. We all know that particular thing. That's not a problem. Okay. So this in turn, if I'm treating with water, H plus. Hydrogenation. H plus or water, whatever it is. Hydrogenation. Everything we are doing, hydrogenation only. Then we'll get phenol. Phenol and nitrogen gas will be there, evaporated. Plus HCl will get excess. So this is not required. For us, the most important thing in this is which one? The phenol itself. You have to write this and this full thing. Clear. This is the most important thing in the examination point of view, right? And with heating, all the thing is exothermic in nature. Everything is exothermic in nature. So preparation of phenol, which means end product should be what? Phenol. So you have to just remember this NH2 thing. So you might be thinking, what is the word of this? This is called aniline. Benzene ring with NH2 is called aniline. Okay. So if you ask me, what is this? This is benzene diazonium chloride. This is benzene diazonium chloride. Diazonium chloride. The last one is phenol. This is important for us. Nitrogen HCl not required. Even for the exam point of view, they'll have the answer key. Okay, and this is actually very easy for us. So once done, let me know. If everyone is completed, just give me a yes. Okay, you're done. That's more than enough. I'll go to the next one. Guys, please study this in the same day. Again, I repeat, chemistry, same day, whatever I teach you, please study it. Okay, so that this should be the most easiest exam for who has faced any difficulty till now. So I'm just going to the next one. Very good. All of you are complete. Perfect. Third one, by the oxidation of cumene. You may be wondering, what is this cumene? cumene is nothing but isopropyl benzene. Do not get worried about these terms. Okay, this is a basic of organic chemistry. Okay, and there is nothing difficult for you. Fine, I'll draw the isopropyl benzene. Benzene, first thing is benzene, I'll draw. Don't get worried by these things. This is my benzene I've drawn. Isopropyl. Propyne. You know what? We know what is propyne, right? Correct? So similarly, I'm just putting a C here. Correct? H here. CH3. CH3. This is my isopropyl benzene or cumene. This is my cumene diagram. This again I'm treating with, I'm heating it, delta, I'm heating with. Heating and hydrolysis, that's all. That is the only process we are doing here is what? Heating this thing, delta is heating and hydrolysis, H plus, okay, or H2O, the boiling water, or I can put H3O plus. Whichever you feel like you can put it. Fine, you can just put delta, no need to by heart anything. Then we'll get what? Phenol and acetone. So again, I want to draw phenol first. So if you can draw with me, it will be very easy for me to go to the next topic and teach you much further than this. Phenol, I'm just putting the OH here. Anywhere you can put. This is a benzene ring. Just putting the OH here, phenol. But the only intermediate product I'll get here is acetone. It's a ketone, basic ketone. CH3CO. So I'm just putting C double bond O, CH3. Acetone. So guys, there is nothing to worry or get afraid by these terms. Phenol. By this chapter, at least you will know what is phenol, OH. This is preparation. Correct. I'm just heating cumene. What is cumene? Isopropyl benzene. Correct. I'm just heating it with water or hydrogenation. Then I'll get phenol. And this acetone is a major product in this. This is a major product. This is an entrance question. If I heat cumene, what is a major product I'll get? Correct. Acetone. This is an entrance question. CET level question. That's all. Once you're done with this, I'll go to the next one. I hope you should be done by now. And one small question to each and every one of you. Alcohols had a higher boiling point, right? Some weak acid or something we told, no? Is it due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding or intramolecular hydrogen bonding? Inter or intra? In alcohols, the boiling point was due to. So I just wanted to know how many of you studied this thing. So that's the reason I'm asking you. The higher the boiling point in alcohol is due to intermolecular or intramolecular? And once you've done this thing, let me know the same. Yes, it is intermolecular hydrogen bonding, correct. I hope you completed this thing. Last one from haloarenes. Correct. Arene in the sense benzene. So this again, we are heating this. Okay, delta of this. And treating with HCl will give us a phenol. So this is a chlorobenzene. So this byproduct will give me what? Phenol. So if we've done this, let me complete it. This thing. Finished. Okay, good. Perfect. The last topic of this is boiling point. Okay. So here phenol is OH, right? Not alcohol OH. It is the high OH thing. Yeah. So please write down everyone, then only I think you'll also get to know. So in phenols, the hydrogen atom is attached with what? With an electronegative oxygen atom, correct? Hydrogen atom is attached with electronegative oxygen atom. Hence it forms, just like in the alcohol, it forms intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Correct? So this implies phenols have higher boiling points than hydrocarbons, ethers, ETHERS. This is my hydrocarbon spelling, okay? Ethers, haloalkene or haloarene, the previous chapter of use. Haloalkane or arene or haloarenes. So this again, the boiling point is what property? Physical property. Correct. So this is a physical property. Done. Okay. So if any everyone has done, let me know. Because we have to write down these things. Yeah. Then only it will be. Then again, after session is all over, also you have to write down. Okay. Two times if you have done, that's it. More than enough. So next thing is chemical properties. Chemical properties. First one, we'll check the acidity of phenols. So how do we check acidity of phenol? If we treat it with metals and alkalis. So if I'm treating anything with, if I'm treating any compound or any element with anything with metal or alkalis, alkali earth metals, this is electropositive metal. Okay, electropositive metal. Electropositive metal or with alkalis, then what will happen? It will form salts. Class 10th, this is actually simple thing. So hence, if I'm treating phenol with, if I'm instead of anything, I can erase and write here what? Phenol, I can write here. I'm treating phenols with electropositive metal or alkali, it forms what? Salts. So hence phenols are acidic in nature. Acidic in nature. So I hope everyone know what is metals, what is alkali. I think everyone knows it. Even if you don't know, I'll tell you that thing. Has everyone completed this thing? I hope everyone has. Nothing is there. So guys, coming to the thing, reaction with metal. Okay, yeah. So I'm just drawing it manually with hand. Reaction with metal. This phenol with a metal. Sodium, I'll take metal. Correct. So what I'm getting here, this is a benzene ring. H is replaced by Na. H is replaced by Na. That's all. Okay. No need to balance. Nothing is required in these kind of things. So I'm getting sodium phenate. This is on reaction with a phenate. P-H-E-N-A-T-E. Phenate. This is on reaction with metal. So I taken here the metal as reaction with metal. I taken here the metal as sodium Na. Same thing. Alkali now I'll do. Okay, the alkali thing I'll do now. So in this I'll taken what? This is again my phenol. Instead of Na, I'll take an alkali, NaOH I'll take. Sodium hydroxide.
correct?
So same thing only I'll get here, sodium phenate thing. Since I've drawn very bad, this is fine, I think so. Same thing, sodium phenate only I'll get. But the only reason is difference is that OH means H2O will come here, correct? But here only hydrogen will be there. This is not required for us. This is not required. That's the reason, correct? This is not. I didn't write this. H2 and H2 are not required. This is on reaction with. This is on reaction with. Alkali. And in entrance, okay, in JE or NEET or whatever it is, any entrance, for me entrance is same, doesn't matter. So these phenols are called Bronsted acids, are called Bronsted acids. Bronsted acids. So how to remember this? Broasted chicken. I hope everyone has heard about this thing, broasted chicken. So if you can remember that thing, you get bronsted acids. So if you ask me, what is this bronsted acid meaning? Which means it can donate a proton. Any acid can donate a proton, right? So here it can donate a proton to a strong base. Donate a proton. This is my two, a strong base. A strong base. Bronsted acids, that's all. Since it is giving me a salt, sodium phenate, and this is again sodium phenate, correct? On treatment with a metal as well as an alkali, I'm getting salts. Hence, I can prove that phenols are acidic in nature, but it is not highly acidic in nature, it is slightly acidic in nature because it is stabilized by resonance. Okay, again, that is not that important. That's the reason I just told you. Completed. Okay. So those are completed. Let me know. Then only. And those who want me to go to the previous page, please let me know. So Emmanuel, that doubt after session is over, I'll explain to you. Okay, Emmanuel. Yeah. How many of you don't know what is alkali? Alkali metals. So what is an alkali basically? Correct. It's a base that dissolves in water. Correct. Sodium is a base. So if I'm just treating with it, correct? So what is the pH of this? It should be greater than 7. That's the only thing. Yeah. So one of the doubt was there. That's the reason I gave. Fine. So it's a base. It's a base. That's all. So metal dissolved in water. That is alkali earth metals. That's what we'll say. Clear. So if it is dissolved in water, we'll get OH minus. That's it. The hydroxide ion, I'll get it. Fine. We'll get OH minus. So I hope Emmanuel, your doubt has been cleared. That's it. I didn't want to take the end of the session. Yeah. Metal dissolved in water. So it will give us OH minus ions, hydroxide ions. That's it. A simple stuff. That's it. Good, good doubt. next important topic for us. Electrophilic substitution reaction of phenols. Correct. Fine. So what is this electrophilic substitution reaction? Or why is phenol undergoing these kind of things? Can anyone tell me? Correct. Electrophiles are, I think everyone knows what is electrophile. Correct? Electron loving groups or electron withdrawing groups. Correct. Anyway, I'll come with an example, then we can do it. Okay. Electrophilic substitution matter, I'll draw this thing. Then only thing you'll get. Nitration. This is my phenol, OH, treated with nitration, direct dilute HNO3, nitric acid, HNO3. Fine, we'll get two things here. This is my benzene only, guys. Okay, I'll erase it and draw. This is the problem if I draw freehand. I'll try to draw as neat as possible. So this is at my ortho position. Okay, so this is called O-nitrophenol. O-nitrophenol. And the other one is my para position, P-nitrophenol. If you want to learn deep on these things, okay, in P-nitrophenol, it is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, O-nitrophenol, it is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So always remember, ortho means what? From this, what you can learn is ortho meaning intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Intramolecular. There's no text to it. That's the reason I'm telling you. P nitrophenol, intermolecular. Inter. One is fine. If you can remember one para as inter, the other will be automatically opposite to that. Fine. So this is for a 2 molecule of HNO3. So suppose I'm giving you this for a 2 molecule of HNO3. So just I'm gonna just wrap it up. See, if I'm giving you a 2 molecule, this is my OH. This is my 2 molecules of HNO3. I'm getting as what? OH is here on the top itself. One is this NO2 and another is this NO2. If I am making it this as, this is ortho and para. Correct. If I am replacing this two, I'm replacing it with 3 HNO3. Then I'll get meta also. Okay. It can come in either here, here or here, anywhere it can. Clear. So if I'm numbering, if it is 2, 4, it can come 2, 4, 6. This is namely for the naming. I'm just doing it for you. That's all. This is again the NO2 here. So 2, 4, 6, trinitrophenol. 2, 4, 6, trinitrophenol. Again, this is also not there in the textbook. I'm just, this is extra information for you guys. Pyrrhic acid. Fine. So it'll again depend upon if it is 3, if it is 2. That's all. 2 means we all know if it is 2, only ortho and para will come. If it is 3 HNO3, it will be 2, 4, 6. Is it clear for everyone? So how many of you want me to go to the previous page? Let me know the same. So like this, you can learn it very easily. So I hope everyone is done with this. Then I can go to very easy things. I can connect and show you a lot of problems along with this. If you're done, let me know. Others will be very easy. Done. Okay. Because I want to just stay here for 5 more minutes. It'll be very easy. Okay. Next thing. What I'm going to teach you next will be very easy things. Again, a phenol I'm drawing here, OH. Correct? And I'm giving what? Bromine. I'll give you your 3Br2. 3 bromine. Then H plus or hydrolysis or whatever it means. So again, the compound which I'll be getting is what? OH will be here. 1Br here, because here I am writing 3Br. One is other Br here, other is other Br here. 2, 4, 6 tribromophenol. And guys, if my handwriting is not good, please tell me that also. Okay, I just want to make sure that you learn it quickly. That's the reason I'm writing it down. So if I'm giving OH, this is my OH plus Br. Br2, if I'm giving. Then again, just like in our previous thing, correct, HNO3 is there, right? Just like instead of that, I'm just giving Br2. Or else I'm giving 2Br. Br2 and 2Br doesn't make much difference. So OH I'll get here again. Write down one more OH. One will be my ortho, O bromophenol, other will be my para. This is my O bromophenol, ortho, and this will be P, para, para bromophenol. This is my ortho, meta, and para. Those who don't, I'm deciding to. Ortho, meta, and para. And this is called what? Halogenation. Halogenation. Not hallucination, halogenation. If everyone is done, let me know. Just like the previous thing. Two important things and this will be done. Completed. Completed. Very important thing. This is going to come for your board exam. The two things which I'm going to tell, especially the this one, which I'm going to definitely come write it and keep it now itself. Without this, there is no paper set. Remark team and reaction. Remark team and reaction. Fine. So Reamer team and reaction, in the sense, this will definitely come. Sure, you can write it down and keep. You can just write it down in chemistry, this thing, it will definitely come. Okay. So this is nothing but CHCl3, that is chloroform. I think everyone knows it. I'm just drawing the phenol here. OH, treatment of phenol. CHCl3 is nothing but what, my chloroform. Those who don't know this thing, is chloroform. Plus sodium hydroxide. Okay, and obviously we will heat it. Obviously we'll heat it. We'll get what? An aldehyde, phenol with an aldehyde will get. Phenol with an aldehyde will get. OH is phenol, aldehyde. Aldehyde is CHO. This is called what? Salic aldehyde. Salic aldehyde. Salic, then just write down salic aldehyde. SALICYL aldehyde, salic aldehyde, salicyl aldehyde. SALICYL. Phenol on treatment with chloroform and sodium hydroxide heated together will give me what? This particular thing. Salic aldehyde. I hope everyone has done that. Kolb's reaction. Again, this is very important for the board as well as entrance. This can come. Okay. Again, phenol, I'll just draw the phenol OH. Correct? And treatment with what? Sodium hydroxide. NaOH, just like the previous thing. And I'm heating with it what? H plus. That's it. And carbon dioxide here. I'll get an acid. So there it was, salic aldehyde. Correct? Here it will be salic acid, that's all. COOH. SALICYL. Instead of aldehyde, I should write what? Acid. That's it. COOH meaning acid. So if you want me to name it, it is 2-hydroxy. OH will be named as what? Hydroxy here. Acid will be given the first preference of 1-2. Correct? 2-hydroxy benzoic acid. Benzene will is replaced by oic acid here. Benzoic acid. So if you have done this, let me know. Two more things, we'll be done. Two more topics and we will be done with this phenols. Yeah. So with this, the last one. The reaction of phenol with zinc dust. Reaction of phenol with zinc dust. With zinc, you can say zinc dust or zinc. This I not see in much of the board exam or entrance examination, but better to prepare this. Also, I just want to remove this phenol thing. Phenol plus zinc will give me what? Benzene. That's it. Benzene in the sense without OH. That's it. Phenol plus zinc will give me benzene, and we have to heat it obviously. Plus ZnO. The last one is quinon. Okay. Oxidation of phenol will give me quinon. Oxidation of phenol. This will be giving me something called benzoquinone. Q-U-I-N-O-N-E. Quinone. Benzoquinone. So I just want to draw the benzene thing here. The phenol thing. This is my phenol. OH. Delta heat or whatever it is. Correct? This is an air. I'll get what? Quinones. Better I'll draw it neatly. A double bonded O and a double bonded O here. This is my benzoquinone. Benzoquinone. This also I not seen in the board exam. Okay, or the entrance examination, but better for us to know. So this is a quinone. If you ask me what is this quinone, it's a pink colored mixture. It's a pink colored mixture. So we can all also obtain by using what? Sulfuric acid also. Okay, sulfuric acid also. If you treat phenol with sulfuric acid, with sulfuric acid also we'll get it. Fine. So what is this double bond O? This is a alpha and beta unsaturated ketone. This is a ketone actually. Double bond O, if it's coming, it's a ketone. So with this our phenols are over.